The equation for inverse distance is in the form of a weighted mean, where we have the z values times the weights divided by the sum of the weights, where wij means the weight for I, the weight for location I and j. So it's that weight is based on the distance, and this equation, 1 over d to the power of 1 in this case, which is inverse distance. So for example here, if we had a location at 20 units away, the weight or its influence at d0, the location at which we want to interpolate the estimate, would be 1/20th of its value observed there, or 0.05. So this line represents 1 over distance to the power of 0. This red curve is 1 over distance to the 0.25. As we increase the magnitude of the exponent of d, such as 1 over distance, then we have something that decreases, still at a decreasing rate, but it decreases at a decreasing rate which is faster than the previous one, and going to 1 over distance squared. This being the most commonly used weighting scheme for inverse distance weights. So let's look at an actual worked example of inverse distance weighted interpolation. We want to estimate or interpolate the value right here, where we see the red dot and the question mark. So what value should that be? Well, that value will be based on all of the surrounding values. We have 100 here, 105, 105, 100, and 115. Intuitively, if we're looking at inverse distance weights, we will know or be able to assume that the most influential points will be the one closer. So this one, for example, will have more influence than this one down here. So 115, even though it's a larger number than 105, will contribute less of that 115 to the prediction or interpolated value here. So first up, we look at the distances. So we get the distance for each of the points. So in this case, both the value of 100 and the value of 105 are both 1.41 distance units away from the location to be interpolated. And so we then draw our inverse distance squared weights here, or line. So this line represents 1 over distance squared. And to get the weights that will be multiplied by each of these values, because they are equidistant from the location to be interpolated, we look at the distance 1.41, we plot it on our graph, and we then read off the weight of 0.503. And we add that to the equation for the inverse distance weighted interpolation from the previous slide. So we have now 100 times the weight, and then 105 times the weight right here. And these are divided by the sum of the weights. So just weight 503 plus 503 goes in the denominator right here. Then we get the next point. So 105 has a distance of 1. So again, we draw a graph with the same inverse distance squared weighting. And we find then that we have 105 times 1. So at 1 distance unit, the weight is 1. So 105 times 1 divided by 1. So we're just adding terms to our numerator and denominator. We'll have a look at the next one. That's 2.24 units away. So the value 100 is 2.24 units away. So again, we look at our graph and find where 2.24 is, and it equates to a weight of 0.199. So we have now 100 times the weight 0.199. And then we also add 0.199 to our denominator. Finally, we have one more point still to consider. That's the one that has a value of 115. And it is 4.24 distance units away from our location to be interpolated. So we draw our graph and we look at 4.24 units on there. And we find out what our weight will be. And it's 0.056. So 0.056 times 115 goes up here. And then the weight itself goes there. Once we do the multiplication and addition, we get 107.95. So our interpolated location's estimate is 107.95. And this just shows the same thing that I just showed you, just as a step-by-step process.